I think it was Michelangelo that used to say that he was trying to liberate the statue from a piece of marble. So for me, it's kind of like trying to discover the device.
We're here to help patients, and that's our number one concern. We want to improve their lives. We want to get them up and moving again. So we are working on new products all the time, working on making sure they're thoroughly tested and designed in the best way possible.
We're testing our existing devices in the way that people actually move, so we better understand how they perform and how we can make them better.
We have a culture here of very careful science and responsible science, which is why we are very confident of what we are doing.
When I ask for a test to be done, I want to be present for a part of the test. I want to see with my own eyes what's going on.
When we design a new implant, we always design them as a system. The implant itself is only one part of it. The other part of it is the surgical instruments.
We focus on designing instruments that help surgeons put in these implants in a more efficient and accurate manner.
But you look at the innovations that we make every day, every year, and we're doing the same thing with surgical tools. We attack the instrument design as thoroughly as the implant team attacks the implant design.
This hallway actually starts with the first patent that was ever issued by Reverend DePuy, who was the founder of the company back in the late 1800s. Every single one of these patents along this wall is something that's going to help a surgeon treat a patient, and that's pretty unique and special.
Our motto is never stop moving, and some of the words that are behind that are just this relentless pursuit of innovation that improves patient care.